some amount of ready business to this new account. So have a clear-cut idea of the candidate's release clauses, or rather relieving clauses, because many a times this becomes an issue once we issue the offer letter. I don't know whether this guy is joining on the 17th day, or the 30th day, or the 45th day. Now we keep calling him, his phone doesn't get picked. Anybody face this within this room? So to onboard this candidate becomes a major gap for us, the recruiters, who've already committed to business. Okay, this guy will be onboarded by the first half of this month. So ref checks and everything are done beforehand, clear-cut idea of the candidate's release clauses, notice period, whether we want to buy it, or he can negotiate within his earlier company to adjust it, waive it off, whatever, or he has 52 holidays or leaves intact, which he can encash when he wants to join, and mutually convenient joining date. It can be a little stretch as well. I mean, if I want him to join on 15th, I can take a date of 30th. So that's a better option. Or else, a lot of things can happen in the families, with due respect. No pun intended, right? So this happens at times. Probably he's also weighing up two more options parallelly. And trust me, which is not in the PPT, at any point of time, if you get hold of a good candidate, if you think it's a right candidature, onboard him. If he is kept lukewarm, all alone, left out in the industry, there are takers as well. So if you think I'm the only organization where he's going to work, no. Onboard him. Yeah? If you have some budget in hand, offer him a small little joining bonus. Small little candies do matter at times. Successful onboarding, once he has passed all these phases, including all documents, all means all, including the relieving letter, or else that becomes a problem when it comes to the performance metrics. First 2 months, when he is chasing his previous employers to get that relieving letter, his performance actually suffers, and it hits the pipeline. You use whatever predictability helpline in form of technology, you cannot measure it. Because he's disturbed, yeah? So introduce the candidate to the reporting manager. Before that, please explain all the benefits, emoluments, entitlements, perks, whether the telephone, the mobile telephone when he uses for official calls, how much is his actual reimbursement, whether it's 1,500 rupees or 100,000 or 2,000. Or else, suddenly, from a sales call, he calls up the HR manager saying, hey, ma'am, what's the entitlement for myself, I mean, when it comes to mobile telephony? Or if I'm from here going to Pune, am I entitled for a cab or a Volvo? Yeah? So that needs to be clarified beforehand. Now, the key performance indicators or job descriptions have to be defined very well once he's onboarded. Now, many times KPIs are related to product mix. Say, suppose there is product A, B, and C. He needs to do A of 30%, B of 40%, and C of 30%. That qualifies him for the incentives. So also, you need to tell him that. Now, revenue generation. If we expect that, I mean, he is supposed to bring in business or revenue worth 2x or 3x of his existing package, that also needs to be told. So it shouldn't come to him as a surprise. Now, next is take the candidate through a structured induction program covering all products and internal processes. So if there is some documentation needs to be done for a client onboarding, irrespective of industry, he has to know it. Or else he needs to go to the cam shop or the operations department to find out what all documents are required actually at the point of time, because he was not properly inducted. So all those gaps can be beautifully plugged during the hiring stage only, yeah? So that's the sharing part of it. Moving to training. Last year, 24th of November, I was discussing, I mean, what all are the current best practices. But trust me, in 10 months, I've seen a whole lot of changes. So last year it was sales training. It had a component called induction. Now that has gone to hiring. That's a pre-cooked stuff, right? I mean, he's been fed with induction. before he actually comes to the sales training platform. Let's see. We have our friends, our partners here, who all are actually enabling them to sell better, make their sales model or process more predictable. How? So the motto is to maintain their revenue streams and stay ahead of the curve. Innovative sales training tools, we've seen a couple of them today. And strategies need to be used by managers in order to ensure that their representatives are qualified and able to consistently increase their output. Just out of sheer passion, I've made a couple of slides which will talk about you. So it might look a little aggressive, but please, bear that with me. Because I personally just noted it down at random. Now, this evolution of training techniques need to be mapped by the managers as they need to use the most effective teaching tools to help their representatives. Self-training has evolved in terms of the use of technology. People are using a lot of video-based programs. Now, instead of telling them a 30-year-old sales process, that's okay, but you tell them how this exists. But tell him that 5 more also do exist. And now show them how to open a call in his industry. Show him 5 opening calls, good opening calls. Now, if he or she sees good opening calls, after seeing 5, role-playing for 2 more, it will be difficult for him or her to make a bad sales call, trust me. The faith comes from, I've done it before. Right? Before I moved into training, I had about 11 years of sales experience in all possible channels. I've sold computers, I've sold computer courses, I've sold Citizen Band walkie-talkies, so everything. I've experimented a lot. At that point of time, there was not a set model which is called about sales training or coaching. So use a lot of e-learning platform, let's say product trainings. Product training does not necessarily mean that you need to engage him for 1 full day and tell him about products, tell him for the day, and then by the time he's dead tired, at 5 o'clock, you take a test. Trust me, it happens in a lot of companies. Again, with due respect. Even a small little Google Doc, create those 20, 25 questions from that particular product, get him tested, give them scores. If he does more than 80%, give him a chocolate, that's good enough. Small little recognition, that works a lot. Now, the slides are a little heavy, so I'll just read them out for you. So, role play scenarios, videos showing role play scenarios, because what happens, unless we show them videos, if we want to role play here, if we want to do a role play, what will happen? The guy who behaves like the buyer becomes too rigid, as if to resist him or her from selling anything. That's a natural phenomenon. So it's better to show videos. And most of us are very, very visual. And if it's added with a lot of good audio, so we tend to watch it, right? And if it's on the higher volume. Now, all these videos can be done in-house, or it can be outsourced if the budget permits. Now, here I'd love to use a small little analogy. Within this room,